Hey, look what I made.
Yeah, that's cute, but I'm going to make this extra large version with these bearings and this printer. Welcome to Beyond Press channel.
Hello.
And today we are going to make world's largest widget spinner. And there has been a couple of attempts of this, but the all other YouTube videos about these, they are made out of plywood or cardboard or something like that. And nobody makes these smaller ones out of cardboard or paper or something like that. So I think those doesn't count. So we have this huge 3D printer. It's Brenta M3 and it has 1 cubic meter of print volume. So we can make quite big spinner out of plastic. And then one other thing that annoys me, you cannot make big spinner out of these small bearings. You need proper bearings like this. And I happen to have a couple of these. So we are going to use these and this printer. And we are going to make one really big one. Yeah, and here is my plan. So here is the 3D files that we are going to print. They are drawn with Vertex Key 4. And these holes are for the bearings. And as you can see, it's actually made from 4 different pieces. And we could make just one really big piece with that printer. It would fit inside of that. That big would be quite challenging, because it might come loose from the table when it cools down, and because of that we decide to make these 4 different pieces instead of just one really big one. And here you can see, when I cut this like this, here you can see how I'm going to put those pieces together. So here are holes inside of the thing between each part, and I'm going to put bolts through these holes, and they are going to keep everything together nicely when it spins. And here you can see technical drawing of the thing, and I made this circle around the thing, and as you can see, its diameter is almost 1 meter or 3 feet, so it's going to be quite large. Yeah, but I think we are ready to start with the printer. So the main part should be now ready. So let's go have a look.
Whoa!
Yeah, it's looking quite good.
This is fat ass spinner.
Yeah, so the idea is to use some screws and attach these here.
Whoa!
And then this goes here and yeah. Looking quite good already, and I think that like other parts make it look even better.
Yeah. This is so cool.
And after we got all parts ready, I realized that 2 of my bearings are wrong size. So we are missing two, but I decided to make just steel weights that are same size as those bearings and use them. And I have video about that process. It's on the end screen and comment, so you can go check that out if you are interested machining steel parts. So the thing is almost ready, but since we replaced the outer bearings with these weights, and they are much heavier than the bearings, and then we also thought that it would be quite funny to be able to spin this really fast, so we replaced the plastic part with the plastic handles in the middle with this. This is steel, and then with these. So then the like support thing on the middle is strong enough. And this has now about 500 of a millimeter gap between this and this, and I'm going to put some Loctite glue there, so then it will get stuck. And it's important not to put this inside of the bearing. Yep. So now it's ready. We have to wait around 15 minutes for the glue settle down, and then we can just screw these on it their place, and then it's ready. So now the glue is ready, and we can install the handles. And let's hope that the holes are on the right place. Yep. Yeah, now it's ready!
Hopefully handles are strong enough.
It's a bit hard to spin, it's quite fucking heavy! I think this is quite good core workout, because it's really heavy to hold like this. I think this should be made out of aluminium, but this is like real man's fidget spinner, not for weak people. So I am without the spinner 94.5 kilos. So I am almost 110 kilograms with this. So it is 15 kilograms. So it's quite hard job to keep it like this. So it's quite a popular test for those smaller ones to spin them with air compressor. But because this is a bit larger, we need a bit larger air thing also.
Part of
is end of this project. It's ready now. And if you have some ideas that we should do with this, please write them down on the comments. And if you want to see more stupid sized 3D prints, please like and share this video, so maybe we then can print also something else also with this big machine.
Yep.
And thanks also to Vertex for their CAD program. It's really good on projects like this. Yeah, but I think that is all for today.
Thank you for watching.
And have a nice day.